Tumult Hype is the HTML5 animation builder for macOS. Version 3.6 introduces many small features to improve your day-to-day flow. Let's dive in. Previously on the iPhone, videos would always go full screen. Hype now has an option for iOS 10 and later to play videos in line within the web page. Videos can also autoplay on iOS 10 if it's first muted. Animated GIF export has been improved to have better reproduction accuracy. In many cases, the file size of the produced GIFs can also be significantly smaller. Exporting as video has some new options. First, the bitrate for H.264 videos can be explicitly set. The Apple ProRes 422 codec can also be chosen for further quality. Tumult Hype can be used for iMessage stickers. There are all the necessary default scene sizes to choose from, and there's also a menu to export as animated PNG. Export scripts help automate workflows involving Tumult Hype's output. They can be developed by anyone and add functionality to Hype, generally helping with advertising tech workflows. In this case, I'll download and install an export script to help with DoubleClick Campaign Manager ads. Once installed, it adds various UI to Hype. This export script will add a click tag field, which I can set to be the ultimate exit point for this ad. Along with this, it adds a new action that can be triggered by a mouse click, and this action will call to that exit. Most importantly, it of course adds an item to the Export as HTML5 menu. This will transform the output, modifying the files and zipping up everything so it's ready to be sent to DoubleClick. There's also functionality for previewing with the export script and setting up advanced export slices to use it as well. We've provided several open source examples and have a lot of documentation if you're interested in extending Hype to help with your export-based workflows. You're also free to use any of the ones that we've provided. Dropbox export has been unfortunately removed. You'll no longer find it in the Export as HTML5 menu. This was done because Dropbox has regretfully discontinued public folder web serving. The resource library now supports multiple selection, so you can mass modify properties like disabling preloading. Dragging files with the same name into the resource library can now replace multiple existing entries. Custom CSS fonts are now editable after they've been created, in case you need to make any changes. This was a highly requested feature. The code editors throughout Hype can now have their font face and size changed in the preferences. This affects the head HTML editor, JavaScript editor, and inner HTML editors. Symbol editing has been improved. When entering or exiting symbols, the outline expansion state is preserved, so that should save from a lot of clicking. Also, if a symbol element is set as hidden, entering into that symbol will now temporarily show it while editing. The zoom out level will go down to 10% to get a much better view for big documents. Zooming is also on a per scene and layout basis, so each one can be zoomed in or out as appropriate for the size. We've added a lot of new JavaScript APIs for getting info and manipulating layouts. The background image property has also been added to the setter API, and there's events for symbol load and unload events. There's a new role field to help provide more accessibility data. The tab index has also been improved, and the Hype JavaScript runtime is much better at laying out elements for iOS voiceover. Microsoft Edge is supported and can now show browser compatibility warnings for any features that they don't actually have. Tumult Hype 3.6 has a wide range of bug fixes and performance improvements, especially related to symbols. And that's what's new in the latest version. This is a free update to existing 2.0 to 3.5 and Pro users. If you're not a user yet, there's a free trial available on our website. We're looking forward to seeing what you build. Thanks.